Start off by making sure our hands are washed. Cleaning all the work surfaces that we're going to be working on. Flour, rolling out it through the pastry dough. With the roller gently, expand it to form like a perfect rectangle. Work with your dough as gently as you can. Then let it rest a bit. Then into a tray with a baking sheet. The baking paper. I'm going to cut my dough inside the tray. This will help me to cut a precise size that I'm looking for. That will also perfectly fit on my tray. Docking with the fork. This will help us to make sure this pastry sheet doesn't kind of like puff up or cleaning as you go. In a preheated oven, after 10 minutes of baking, I have to flip it over and cook the other side. Flipping it over, can see it's a bit moist at the bottom, so I'm going to cook this top side now. It's about 15 to 20 minutes. Then now my dough is ready. On a rack to cool. Leave it to cool down. Trying to zoom the golden perfect color that I was looking for. Okay, I'm going to be cutting this sheet into precisely 3 equal strips that I'm going to be layering. Ensuring that they are precisely equal, no overlapping, and trimming off any excess to give a clean, kind of like looking product. Keeping up with the clean as you go procedure. Using my pre-made pastry cream that has been in the fridge, trying to bring it back to life. I'm going to fill my piping bag with this pesto cream, which after I'm going to be piping over layers of pastry or strips of pastry. With a spoon, gently fill in my piping bag. Gently pushing it forward to the nozzle on a paper. I'll layer the first strip. Pipe and smoothen out with my spoon. Add more layer. Just to give my cream some height. Also ensuring that the cream doesn't create a mess, just covering the top part of the strips. I'll do the same with this strip also. Piping. So here is basically layering cream. Just trying to create that, then smoothen out. Then top with the remaining strip. On this one, I don't have to be putting a pastry cream. This one, I'm going to be using a smooth jelly to brush on top to create what is called a key. Pressing gently. You can see I've created a bit of mess. There is no problem, I'll clean it out. Trying to zoom close, how so far it's looking. Trying to keep my place as clean as possible. My clear jelly. Brush the top. Remove from the paper into my baking tray. That's where I'm going to be onwards working from. I'm going to be using water to smelt my chocolate, which is basically called tempering. This really does help to ensure the amount of heat that is transferred to the chocolate is not as excessive, which is ideal for tempering the chocolate. It's one of the most recommended methods to smelt your chocolate. It is completely smelted. It's also control the heat of the water. It doesn't have to boil. It has to be just hot enough to. Okay. Warm the fondant. Just seconds would be good enough to keep it going. It doesn't have to exceed 37 degrees. So here, so I'm going to put equal amounts of chocolate melted with equal amount of the fondant. I'm also measuring the amount of fondant that I'm going to put inside the chocolate, so it has to be equal. Mixing thoroughly to ensure we've got a smooth product at the end of the day. Mixing the last jelly with my fondant. Also, this does help to give me a finished, glossy final product after I spread on top of the mealy fuel. Okay, layering on top of the mealy, spreading also gently so that you avoid creating a mess. So there are a lot of things to consider on this one. The thickness, in a way that it shouldn't be runny, it has to be able to cover, as you see. Then my chocolate poured into unfortunately on this one I didn't have the smaller mouth of piping bag, I used the corner of the plastic, but I believe it can get the job done. I'll just make sure my lines as long as it gets the job done. I feel like I've been let down with my plastic, but though on artistical side it looks impressive, I'm happy with the outlook. Yeah, so I have to let it rest after I've cleaned, then afterwards when it has settled, the jelly, the mixture of fondant is gelatinized, then cutting into portions. It's really looking perfect, I would say. I'll split in two pieces. Yeah, can see it here, jelly is glossy, shiny, it's really looking yummy. Yeah, I'll be garnishing with some fruits that I had, just to give it a little bit of color and make it look like a happy meal, the way it looks like worth 100 million right now. Trying to zoom close, it's close, shiny, really looking nice. Also my fruits are doing a very good job in uplifting the look of my dish, trying to show all the angles around. So now I'm trying just to kind of like cut to show how it really came out, the jelly on top, how it has gelatinized, or the fondant thing is not cracking, it's smooth, it's glossy, at the same time as I've missed the jelly, it's like jelly but really looking yummy. So that's the whole point that I'm trying to really emphasize or show. It's really yummy. One of those dishes that I can put out there and be having a peace of mind. It will be a success to whoever will be served. Yeah, I'm trying to show the jelly. Maybe I have to zoom in with my camera just to show Thank you again. I feel like I have did my job very well. I'm impressed, I'm happy with the outlook. Next time.